What is going on, everybody? How you doing today? Jim Games Live here, and in today's video, I'm going to be continuing my journey with the band Måneskin. Now, last week, I reacted to my very first Måneskin song, and it was Torna Casa, I think was the name of the song. I'm probably butchering that. I'm really sorry. My Italian is pretty bad. But this week, I wanted to try something different. So I went through the comments of what everybody left in the last reaction, and this one came up, and someone just wrote, "This song is a masterpiece." And I'm like, oh. Well, okay, I'll check that one out next. The song is called Coraline, and I wanted to do this one as well because as much as I liked the last song, I thought it was very beautiful and vibrant, and there was just so many different textures, and the vocal melodies, and just the structure of the song was very intriguing and very, very well put together, but I felt like I was really missing something by not understanding those lyrics. As visually and sonically pleasing as it was, I felt like there was a piece of that picture that I was truly missing. So this week, I thought it'd be kind of fun to start off with a song that would have English translations down below so I can kind of understand maybe just how they write or what they write about. So we're gonna find that out today. If you're new around here, please consider liking and subscribing. It would help me out a ton and I truly appreciate it. And let's get right on into it. Let's switch screens and let's check out Coraline. Here we go.
Dimmi la tua verità, Coraline, Coraline. 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 Coraline bella come il sole, corriera dal cuore zelante, capelli come rose rosse, preziosi quei fili di rame, amore portali da me. Se senti campane cantare, vedrai Coraline che piange.
Okay, let's just talk about what we're hearing so far. It's very simple. We have guitar and vocal. Guitar is playing a very, very simple melody. The vocals are still expressive, done in a very delicate way here. There's some natural rasp to his voice. It sounds like there's some sort of sadness to it, and or maybe some sort of animosity in his voice. Like you can just kind of feel that emotion. That passion kind of oozing out of this guy. And from what I can tell from the lyrics so far, it seems like he's telling a story here. It seems like it's going in some sort of like, I don't know, it's almost done like in a way that it would sound like it's like a fairy tale almost, I guess, maybe. But a couple of lines here that are like, hitting me here is like, he's saying, you know, Coraline, she's beautiful, you know, she's, you know, everything, but she seems to be carrying some sort of pain with her at this point. And she's maybe not seeing the beauty of herself. Maybe that's where the song is going. I don't know. We're only a couple seconds into the song. Let's let the story play out and, see what kind of conclusion we can come to. Love his melodies.
Però lei sa la verità. Non è per tutti andare avanti con il cuore che è diviso in due metà. È freddo già. È una bambina, però sente come un peso. E prima o poi si spezzerà e la gente dirà. Non vale niente, non riesce neanche a uscire da una misera porta. Buongiorno.
Interesting. It started off as like what I was assuming was, you know, the narrator who would be the singer talking about Caraline or Coraline, and it like sounded like she had some self-doubts of herself, but he was saying that she was pretty. But these last couple lines that are coming in, they're telling us that no, people are gonna shoo her away. They want her out the door. So maybe she did do something absolutely terrible. I don't know. I feel like there's definitely a lot more to this story, but it seems like she has some self-doubt and possibly even some self-hate herself, and then also some other people too. Just want to push her to the side as well. So it leads me to believe that these aren't anxieties that, you know, someone would feel, and there's nothing actually there. It feels like she actually may have done something, but she's absolutely devastated by it so far. Hopefully, the song will tell us. But let's continue here. See right here, and people will say she's worth nothing. She can even walk out the stupid door. Yeah, it seems like people are just like pretty bummed with her too. I don't know.
Non vale niente, non riesce neanche a uscire da una misera porta. Buongiorno, una volta lei ci riuscirà.
It ends on a positive note. I like that. I dig the indie tone.
The detto Coraline che può crescere, prendere le sue cose e poi partire. Ma sente un mostro che la tiene in gabbia, che le ricopre la strada di mine. Detto a Coraline che può crescere, prendere le sue cose e poi partire. Ma Coraline non vuole mangiare, no. Sì, Coraline vorrebbe sparire. E Coraline piange, Coraline all'ansia. Coraline vuole il mare, ma ha paura dell'acqua.
Oh, like a line.
Forse il mare è dentro di lei.
Oh my god, I do. I love some of these lines right here. All right, this man is actually a poet. He's actually a poet. So this, where the story is taking me now, and I could be completely off base here. I'm just throwing things out here as I hear them. Maybe it seems like she's living with her father, and her father is basically saying, hey, once you're old enough, you can just leave. So maybe she didn't do horrible things. Maybe her dad's just a jerk. Maybe that's what's happening here. She loves the sea, but she's afraid of the water. She doesn't want to eat because she'd rather just disappear. So it's, I am loving some of these lines here. It's something about this guy's voice too. Like he expresses passion, and like, I don't know. It's very invigorating. It's very, I don't know. It's fun to follow. Let's continue this little jam because we're starting to pick up here.
Che può crescere, prendere le sue cose e poi partire. Ma Coraline non vuole mangiare, no. Sì, Coraline vorrebbe sparire. E Coraline piange, Coraline all'ansia. Coraline vuole il mare, ma paura dell'acqua.
Love that.
E forse il mare è dentro di lei. E ogni parola è un'ascia, un taglio sulla piena, come una zattera che naviga in un fiume in piena. E forse il fiume è dentro di lei, di lei.
They leave it as a maybe too. Maybe this sea's inside of her. Maybe this river's inside of her. It's an open-ended question.
Sarò il fuoco e il freddo, riparo d'inverno. Sarò ciò che respiri, capirò cosa hai dentro. E sarò l'acqua da bere. Del bene, sarò anche un soldato, ho la luce di sera, e in cambio non chiedo niente, soltanto un sorriso, ogni tua piccola lacrima, oceano sopra il mio viso, e in cambio non chiedo niente, solo un po' di tempo, sarò vesti lo scudo, ho la tua spada.
Such interesting choices of words. I like the solos too. The last song I listened to had a solo too, and it kind of followed that same formula here, where it wasn't like something that just kind of like ripped your face off, or it wasn't like shredding metal. It was a solo that kind of like went along with the melodies and kind of the vibe and the theme of the song, and kind of held on to that. And to me, that's artistic integrity. They're pushing the song forward, but they're doing it in a way without outshining anybody else here. It's obvious that we're dealing with some very phenomenal musicians here. The drum and bass work so far, which I haven't even touched on, is actually pretty dang impressive on its own. I'll touch on that after the video, but I just wanted to mention something here about the guitar solo, because it's just so prevalent in the mix we were just hearing. It's simple enough where it's, you know, it's catchy, it has some flow to it, but it stays that simple where it keeps the artistic integrity of this jam going. And I've said it a million times, I love it when artists do that sort of things, because they're essentially taking themselves out of the picture and pushing the picture of the art forward, and that seems to be the case with these guys. Oh, is that the end of the song? Just ends like that?
Dimmi la tua verità.
No, they're dramatic as hell. They're going to let the guitar ring out, and they're going to continue the story. Just a solid, what, 2.5, 3 seconds of dead air. I love it. I absolutely love it. That's almost 9 seconds.
Coraline, bella come il sole, ha perso il frutto del suo ventre, non ha conosciuto l'amore, ma un padre che di padre ha niente, le han detto in città c'è un castello, con mura talmente potenti, che se ci va a vivere dentro, non potrà colpirti più niente, non potrà colpirti più niente.
Wow, gorgeous, it came back around full circle. Let me turn this down just a little bit, and I kind of want to talk about that. So yeah, this is my first experience analyzing some of the lyrics of Måneskin. Like I said, this is the only second song I've ever heard from this band, but I definitely wish to continue, all right? Because everything I've heard right now, it's been checking off all of the boxes of things that I find interesting. They are incredibly dynamic and expressive musicians, especially this vocalist here. But what's happening with the band, too, is nothing to sleep on. There's a lot of really cool things happening there as well. But it seems like this is a group of artists that are truly pushing the art forward and not just falling into the same pocket of how music should be created. And just all showing off and muddying up the final picture. They seem to get that. Måneskin seems to definitely get that. And I feel stronger about that opinion now after having the time to sit down and analyze at least some of the lyrics here. Now, do I know exactly what they were about, or have I nailed the story down? No, I probably haven't. What I'm getting on my first listen through of this is it sounds like she may have done something really bad. They mentioned her womb at one point in time, so this song might be about abortion and her father's displeasure with that, or maybe her father made her get an abortion because she didn't like the boy, or she was too young, or whatever the case may be. I could be completely wrong on that. But it seems to be telling a story in a fairy tale kind of format here. It feels like there's several people asking questions, and it seems like the narrator who's singing to her wants to know more, but she's like kind of shying away from everything. It's wild. Some of the lines in this song too are fantastic. The line about she wants the ocean, but she's afraid of the water. I mean, that just kind of resonated with me. And then how she talks about how maybe it's inside of her anyway. Maybe she just has all these things just spilling up and swollen up like that river inside of her, and it's going to come out at some point. Yeah, absolutely beautiful. And then the way the song ends too is it talks about how about she might want to move to this castle where the walls were just won't hurt her. There's something going on there too. I guarantee I'm missing a lot, but please just forgive me. It's my first listen through of this song. These are just my kind of initial reactions. My initial reaction, I guess. So the lyrics, I love them. I absolutely love them. I like the fact that they're telling a story. I like the fact that there's some incredible clarity in the words. Everything is just so audible. Having this song sung to you in a beautiful language like this, I mean, it just puts a different spin on things, you know? It's just, I don't know, you're able to enunciate things in a different way when it's in Italian as opposed to just English, you know? And it just sounds... It sounds different, but it sounds familiar at the same time. And I find that exciting because I'm in my American bubble over here, and I'm hearing kind of the same thing over and over. And it excites me when I can find an artist like this. Let's talk a little bit about the band here and about what they did and what they brought to this this piece of art here. Like I said, there's a lot of simple things happening in ways that are letting other people shine without overshadowing each other. Like, they're just letting the vocalist guy here, I'm sorry, I don't know his name, they're letting him just shine. They're letting him do his thing, show true expression by playing some simple harmonizing melodies. The drum and bass work on this is absolutely brilliant from a minimalistic point of view. We're hearing expression off of things of, like, how a cymbal, the ride in particular, was recorded. We're hearing the clap, or the actual hit from closer to the bell of the cymbal, which is giving us more of a bell sound. This brought down lower in the mix, but it's a fun little recording technique there. The guitar, the tone has this really interesting, kind of gritty indie type feel to it. It feels very rock and roll, but it also has like that kind of indie vibe to it. This little solo I already touched on, It's simple. It's just do 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 do. Again, what they're doing is they're playing accent melodies almost half of what he was singing in the previous verse. So it's still carrying this song forward, but it's just adding that extra layer to it. Man, these guys leave you wanting more. That's for sure. They absolutely leave you wanting more. I think the next thing that I should probably do is check out what can they do live. How do they sound live? Because I saw the music video. I now know that they can write very good lyrically. I mean, this is straight up poetry is what this is. You know, this isn't just, ow, now, brown cow. Like, it's not just like rhyming, you know. It's not talking about, you know, stupid things like, look at my girls in my arms and how many cars I have in the garage. Like, it's telling a story, and it's telling it in such a passionate and intriguing way that just kind of keeps you latching on the entire way. These guys are interesting. These guys are interesting for sure. I want to hear more, but I think the next one I should do is a live performance. If you guys have a live song from Måneskin that you think that I would enjoy to see or that can really tear apart, please let me know down in the comments. Share the link, whatever you got to do. I would truly, truly appreciate it because I feel like that's the next evolution of learning about this band is just seeing what they can do live. But yeah. Absolutely enjoy this one. Awesome recommendation. Any other music, please leave it down in the comments. Like I said before, I also have some links down there. My community Discord, if you want to chat offline, off stream or whatever. Best way to do it is to join the community. A lot of really cool, like-minded people there in the Discord. And then also, I have a Twitch link. I do live reaction shows every Wednesday and periodically throughout the week. Check out the Twitch link, dude. It's a lot of fun. We float a lot of bands around, and it's just always a good time. So if you enjoyed your time with me today, please like and subscribe. And that's going to do it for me, guys. Have a great night, everybody. Bye now.